capital of England is actually F420. That's an MC. So here we are, acting as the opening government. US is silence you. I hope you are not silent forever. And
ladies and gentlemen, you can hear what actually the society's judgment about the women who do such kind of prostitution, ladies and gentlemen. They call this prostitution as a bitch. They call them sluts. But how about the men itself, ladies and gentlemen? They don't call any men as they are, as the prostitution itself. Second example, on how actually you are as the woman who follow such kind of social structures, that you are joining the free nipples movement, on how actually the woman can do such kind of things, like the shirtless things, that reflects the idea of feminist itself, ladies and gentlemen. Don't you think that that is the idea that that should not be regretted since the first time of ladies and gentlemen? We believe on the idea of the norm and also the morality on how actually this why actually this norm and also the morality should still be considered by the feminist movement. We believe in the idea of norm, no thanks, where the people still stick to the word of tradition itself, ladies and gentlemen. How important is this morality and also norms for the society? Because of this kind of norm on and also morality should be kept in line with the society perspective and also the society's judgment. In this case, ladies and gentlemen, we are still having such kind of people, like conservative people. We're still having such kind of religious people that still accommodate their values in the society itself, ladies and gentlemen. We cannot even believe that we can easily erase the sexism itself because of what? Because of sexism is always there since the first time. But on how actually we believe on the idea of norm and morality itself should also be in line with equality, which is actually a dream by this kind of a third wave feminist itself. Yes.
So number one, we are not changing a paradigm. For example, when we're doing slut, and it's not moral, it's morality or not. But probably that we should compatible to the will of the women to liberate the rights of the women. How do you address this case?
Yes, the right of the women itself. But on how actually this right should be taught by feminism itself is coming because of the demand of the equality from this movement, right? We know about this. But on how actually the government has provided such kind of the first wave and also the second wave of the feminist movement itself. But how actually the rights will be a trigger because of what? Because of the woman itself won more in this equation, ladies and gentlemen. But on how actually the control of the freedom since the first time should also be in line with the condition, right? The government should also control the freedom given by this feminist movement because of the moral and also norm that I have told you before. Yes.
So we think that you don't know the case of the third wave feminism that compatible to third world countries that access currently. How you address this case of third world countries?
Yes. We don't know the third world countries still have their conservative people, right? These third world countries also still have their religious people. That's why there is the circumstance of where actually the feminist is applied. Third of all, we are taking the case of the people, especially the women, when there is a criminal case happen because of this third wave feminism. What is the case? The rape case, ladies and gentlemen. How actually this rape case can be a really spread to the society, and how actually the victims of this rape, the rape case is actually increased because of the society itself, especially the women, are not aware and using this third wave feminist as the camouflage, ladies and gentlemen. On how actually we believe that this, whether or not if this woman having such kind of third wave feminism that they thought, but on how actually this kind of thing will trigger to the criminal case itself. These women will be raped because of they are having such kind of no shirt in heels and money. You can imagine on how actually the condition of the society is the condition of society are various. You can actually easily got the man that actually cannot control their desire as the human being, as man. This is actually why the rape case itself cannot be avoided. And on how actually the third world feminism is actually the thing that can be regretted because of this third world feminism promotes this rape case and also criminal case happens. Yes.
we are not going to ask the women to do slut walk in the third world countries, but what we are going to do is that we should encourage the women to get education. For example, the issue of the Middle East right now, women are being oppressed towards their conditions of their rights.
Yeah, we don't, yeah, that is actually the concept given by the feminism in the first and also second, right, not the third. Fourthly, we are believing on the idea of the objectification of the woman itself, that we think that the objectification of the woman will be there. On how actually all the norms and also moral of the woman itself is neglected in here. You can easily get the women being naked. If you follow the rules by this third wave of feminism, you can easily get how actually the stigma and also the society's mindset can change because of this. They are not following any tradition anymore. This is actually a very crucial issue on how actually we believe also on the idea of the perspective of the society. We know that these feminists are seek for the equality between the men and also the women. By the time in the past, these women actually have got what they have gotten. They are actually seeking the basic legal and also the political rights of themselves. The government has given. The society mindset has changed this month. And the second, they are giving such kind of the special right to go up this month, to get their second wave feminism. And the government also accepted this month because the government thinks that it's okay for them, which is basically they are still in line with the norm and so the moral of the society. And how actually the third our feminism itself works, Lesman. This is the thing which is out of the context of the feminist itself, when the feminist could is still being kept by the traditions. You cannot make this feminist or this woman can be simply become the same as the man itself that can show their nipples, for example. They can show their body, for example. And the next is, we are believing on the society's judgment on how actually the society consists of many conservative society, and also they believe on the idea of the children that will be impacted as another actor and so on. Thank you.
Basically, the base reasons of why the government sides actually regret the rise of the third wave feminism is because they actually believe that women should not actually wear an open clothes, that women should actually close their clothes and walk around in a very conservative way, and that because, you know, men can rape you. But one thing that they actually forget is that their idea is basically the reason, is basically what the feminists oppose in the first place, right? Because basically, the feminists believe in the idea of equality, right? If men can actually do something, then why can't the women do it? So it's pretty much the same idea in the feminist case, in which if men could actually be naked, if women could actually not wear any clothes, then why can't the man and the girl actually do that, right? So we think that this actually promotes further the idea of equality themselves, right? So we don't think that their cases is actually relevant in a way. Because even if you say that, you know, men can rape you, this is promoting the man cases, we think that if the government actually wants to change their proposals, if the government wants to create a policy, we think that the government could create more policy on how the man should actually to prevent the man from doing the rape rather than actually beating the woman and putting all the blames on women. Because it's not the women's fault, right? In the end of the day, we think that the women do what men usually do, and the men did not get obsessed by that, right? So we think that in the end of the day, this actually shows an improvement in how the women can actually, you know, express their right further. And they also talk about the society judgment, how this will affect how the feminists view the girl, the society view the feminists. Well, practically, we don't think this is pretty much out of the context, because feminists' idea, the idea of feminists, isn't basically to be liked by society, but they want to promote the idea of feminism, right? So we think that this society judgment would not bother feminists in any way, because that's why, you know, feminists were actually really active in, you know, promoting their idea. They did not care what the society think, because it's not their goal to actually being liked by the society. Now, firstly, we don't really understand what is their reasons of regret in the first place. So let's just say for this Mayuka, we think that, you know, you regret something when there's actually a degradation in this value. Now, in this case, we want to say that we think that the degradation in value of feminism did not actually happen in the first place. In fact, we think that they are actually evolving, right? Because basically, what the third wave feminists do is that they are stopping women from pitting one against each other. Now, we know that, you know, in the second wave feminism, you know, you should not actually go into a sex industry, for example. You should not actually wear makeup because it's very unnatural and that actually shows your body being dominated by men. And what happens if there's a woman that actually enters this kind of industry where women wears makeup? Well, they would be categorized as slut. What happens in the second wave feminism is there is a clash between these feminists, between the feminists that actually want to support their body. That's why the third wave feminist exists as the one that shows that, hey women, if you want to be liberal, if you want to enter a sex industry, it's okay, it's your right to do so because you are, we are supporting equality, because men actually do that. We think in term, in the idea of equality, we think that this is actually an improvement, right? Because this shows that the women are much more liberal, they could do whatever they want to, rather than being oppressed like what happened in the in what happened before. And we think that this also extends especially towards the middle, to the third world country. Now we see that this third wave country is more active in, you know, promoting the idea of feminism, right? Even to the other countries, right? Rather than what happens in the second wave, because so we think that this actually works because even in countries like Middle East, for example, you know, women are being oppressed, they should not even drive, they are believed that they should not work. We think that here comes the way, the purpose of feminists, you know, to promote the idea of feminists, of that girl that you are worth it, that you should not listen to what the society or the culture thinks you. We think that this feminist is not coming from the government like what they said. This feminist come from the society. In fact, this feminist is the one that came to the government and said, hey government, there's something wrong with the, within your regulation and you should create a different. That's why this that's why this third wave feminist is should not be regrettable. Now, before we move on, we should say, yes?
Don't you think that the feminists, they are actually looking for acceptance instead of rights?
Exactly, right? When you before you actually ask for rights, you actually need acceptance. But this acceptance could not happen when the women did not work together, which actually what happens in the wave before, right? Like what I said to you, that women, when they actually wear something quite opening, they quite open, you know, they would actually be oppressed by the other women that claim that they are feminists as actually the second wave feminists. Now, what we are trying to, what basically the feminists want is basically they want to be accepted by the women, right? They are not trying to be accepted or being liked by the society in a way. So they want to support the women themselves. So like we think that this is this third wave feminism is especially evolving because they are actually much more personal, like they are much more universal and accessible, right? They can do whatever what they wanted within their scope of their country. For example, Middle East, you should do what you want to. You can actually drive. You can actually do what you want if it's what you wanted to. So like so we think that this third wave feminism is actually evolving rather than what they claim to be degradation, because we think that your norm and morality did not actually exist, because basically what happened is that men actually did that too. So what I've shown to you today, we think that this could be a form, this third wave feminism is a form of protection towards these feminists themselves, right, which are being oppressed, which did not actually know of the existence of feminism before, even in the Middle East countries. So, and also second point is we think that this is actually the evolving of the idea of feminism themselves, where they are not being bound by the values that defines you as feminist. If you want to be a stay-at-home mom, then so be it. If you want to be an independent woman, then so be it, right? Because you are a liberal woman. So we think that, you know, if you want to be feminist, there's no boundaries that defines who you are. And that's what we think is equality, right? That means that you, there's no more gender stereotypes, there's no more role expectation, which feminism is trying to combat in the first place, right? So we think that this is, at the end of the day, this actually could help in terms of supporting the feminists themselves. So yeah, I rest my case.
Yeah, yeah.
we regret it because it brings more harm than benefits. It's quite obvious. In this case, they are demanding the freedom, while in our case, we believe that the too much freedom is harmful toward them. In first case, to respond to the open opposition case is that they are trying to give equality through the acceptance of the rights. We believe that acceptance itself will not be achieved because rights itself do not change the perception of the stigma of the society. Rights only grant a special treatment, not how to change the stigma itself. So therefore, we can still easily assume that their proposal will not work because what's important is how much we must import in trying to change the stigma in society instead of giving the special treatment. We can change the stigma from giving a campaign or anything whatsoever. So we believe that the interest itself of the papers, they are seeking acceptance instead of rights, and acceptance itself could only be achieved by only government trying to start to change the stigma itself. So now first, I'm going to tell you on how this feminist movement, the status quo right now, it has been victimizing themselves. The feminist nature of women is that women have more aesthetical value compared to men. Women have their own breasts, women have their own assets, their own asset. So therefore, we believe that the purpose of the asset is that, we are debating on the rape, in the raping case is that, the purpose of the asset is for the sake of, to attract the opposite gender, to provoke sexually. We believe that such kind of assets should be used to exercise carefully, so it kept aside with a good caution, because we know that we could not generalize all that we are living in a utopian society. We should be aware that society itself consists of many personality, many types of people. Some people, let's say just some of society, are consists of horny men, and we believe that when that happens in the society, unfortunate incident they make me happen. For example, rape, and we believe that this is totally not totally the fault of the rapist, because we believe that in the idea of justice is that a crime is only occurs because when there's a motivation or opportunity. Because therefore we believe that this is partially the fault of the female as well, because of due to the analysis of cause and consequences. So therefore we believe that their proposal at the end of the day will fire the idea of justice, because they are undermining men. Because of their proposal at the end of the day, they are going to blame men for everything that happens back to the women. Second of all, we believe on the idea on how too much freedom itself is not good, because we believe that freedom limitation is important, because you cannot control the freedom, because you're not living in a utopian society, and not everyone are good people. So therefore, the female people itself, they still not need protection in order to control themselves, to be careful in case of the bad things happen, because due to the idea of just criminal itself. Now, the rest of the feminist movement itself, they are going to send a bad message to the society on how they are treating themselves, they are portraying themselves as if they are being oppressed, while in reality, they are not, because we know the status quo is already enough on how the feminists, the female people, they have an equal opportunity, they have equality based on education, and in terms of anything, in terms of pursuing their happiness, it's just a matter of how they want to exploit themselves, which is why we case in their case itself should not be true. Limitation itself is totally important, because I proved to you on how a proper dressing could lead you to a better lifestyle. Because by having a proper dressing, let's say you are able to avoid the rape case, or even avoid the things that objectify women. We believe that the idea of gender equality is that they are seeking the same treatment for society. We believe that that kind of idea is impossible to be happened, because sexism will always exist, discrimination will always exist due to the differences between male and female itself. The difference itself could not be denied, because they are different in terms of physical way. And let's say the idea of physical is that the main difference is the idea of how women could get pregnant. Now, we believe that it's totally unchangeable in terms of the idea of unproductivity. But however, the status quo right now is already enough, because of the differences, society also have the restorative capacity, society have their own choice. So therefore, in the idea of totally equality, it will never be achieved.
Right. We think that the idea of oppression should always be done forever, and there should not be a parameter for society to regret this. If a woman goes to be a prostitute and if beyond that person, what is going to be wrong anyway?
Now, the first thing is that we believe on the idea of human rights, on how men and female they have already equal opportunity, they could gain respect from the society from the very first. Now, to respond to the rapist case, we believe on the idea of how government's moral obligation to protect affluence of society, including the male and the female. We believe on the idea of culture or the idea of religion that has been inherited from the past ancestors. Historically, the male people they are believed to have more value compared to the women due to the contribution of the past that they can make during the past. The physical difference is, for example, in the idea of building of construction, being a workforce labor. So therefore, we believe that from the first, men are the benefits. Yes.
What you're basically regretting is the idea of feminism themselves, right? Basically, how are these actually termed with feminism? Actually,
we totally support the idea of the first wave and the second wave of feminism itself, because the first wave and the second wave, they are the most fundamental rights. The first wave itself is the idea of political rights. The second wave is the idea of how women should be granted to the men to live. These two rights itself are the rights of to granted to appreciate the differences between two genders. The one on the other and the third wave itself, they are seeking too much freedom. If this freedom itself is the one that's been helpful toward them, toward society as well, because we also may not forget how society also conserves of the people that consists of people that's being conservative stick to their own religious value. We believe that in our current society, in order to feel that be accepted, people at least need to live with the cultural fact that is being agreed by the society itself. And we believe on the idea of the harm, the further harm is on how it will damage some important part of society. Even though we are debating on the liberal democratic societies just like the USA, we believe that the conservative people still exist. We believe that the third part, the term of feminist demands are go opposite with the religious value. For example, the freedom in dressing, they are promoting how women should be exposing their asset in the freeway, seducing men widely. Now, we believe that this is not against the value of religion, because it is enraging the conservative public on how they have their own belief, and we believe that by government supporting itself, government is insulting the value of religion itself. Government support will be insult to the religion, which is being believed by the international world itself. So, in short, itself, government against religion is totally not okay, because government are going to violate the believers' belief, because eventually society are going to be confused on what is right or wrong. Society will not be able to achieve on how to pursue their happiness. So, in my case, I tell you on how the harm is totally the additional rights could bring more harm than benefits, because the feminists itself, they demanded so many freedom, and the freedom itself uncontrollable and it's totally irrational. So.
To represent you guys. So we think that the problems of the feminism right now is not complicated like they talk about, but they propose why they should regret the rights of the third wave feminism. It is third wave feminism will show to you what the women should look like, why the women should get the more advanced rights in front of the society. It is promise that they're talking about the moral degradation, how at the end of the day, women is defined by religious or culture. We don't think that women should be defined as the culture or religion. Yeah. The culture is kind of changeable. Maybe in the past, for example, women are oppressed to handle the domestic issue. Women cannot go to the education. But right now, women are able to pursue their education. This is the thing that why the culture can be changed at the end of the day. Second of all is that the religion. We don't think that why you think that women can do can wear whatever they want, the people will change their perceptions. Even people cannot believe to the certain idea, for example, like Muslim, how the women should like to use hijab. For example, when women use, for example, the open book or sex book, women are not able to protect themselves. Even women degrade the value of their body. But we don't think so. Because we think that the problem of feminism, they're looking for the equality. They're looking for what the society is not talking about, the acceptance that they're talking about. Because when we're talking about acceptance, we believe that we cannot see that all the people, for example, conservative people, should accept the women as look like, for example, use the sexiest clothes or so on. We think that that's okay for the conservative not accept it. But the problem as the whole of the majority, how the feminism, the third wave, will introduce you for the women to get their opportunity in terms of the work, so and so on. It is problems that they talk about, for example, like when men, they prostitute themselves, for example, when they become sex workers, it's okay, we don't think so. Because even that men, we can call men as the gigolo, right? It means that we'll tell you why, even if you are going to the prostitute, you are not going to blame the women. It means that man too is going to be, you know, underestimated towards the other society. We don't think that their case is talking about the man or women is going to be prostitute. So number one, I'm going to talk to you about the historical backgrounds, why the oppressions of women in the past will give the impact to the rights of women. And second of all is that I'm going to talk to you is that why we should liberalize the feminism to
towards the rational thought that happens in the society. Within the problems that, number one, within the women are oppressed by, for example, the historical, for example, women like in the third world countries right now, when they are not able to achieve their rights, for example, because of the religious issue. They cannot get the high education, for example, they cannot go to work, even they only can do the housewife task. Within that, it's not going to be okay. Why? Because this time, it only makes the women is depend towards the men, right? Because of the feminists right now is the advocate to help and encourage women whatever they want to achieve, whatever they want to be success. This is what we think that advocacy of the women and the feminism right now is compatible with all the countries, with the wave of the countries that happens in the current status quo. It means that when we see that the historical, for example, women is a part of the imperial party, for example, can only handle the domestic issue and the irrational thought towards their decision. For example, when you use the sexist clothes, so you are blaming the women because of you are a sexual object to attract the women and to attract the men to rape you. But the problem is that we don't think so, because when you think that women are the sexual object, it means that you only put the women and you only limit the women to get the expression, to the way they dress. It means that women are able to to use whatever they want as long as they're not harm to their people. This is the way why the feminist movement to encourage the women. And second of all, we think that they're talking about the capabilities of women. For example, like women in this country, for example, they are because of the conservative should undermine should define the women look like. We don't think so. Because of within the capabilities of women is not because of what we call it because they are not able to achieve this situation. Because when you think that the thought of the women is irrational and they are so sensitive, and you think that, for example, like women right now cannot able to do the man job because of women don't have the power, we don't think so. Because of women right now is achieving their rights to be rational thought in society. For example, they can have the beginning power in politics. They have the beginning power towards the, for example, towards the man, how they can get the equal opportunity for men to get better education, to compete together. It means that why the wave of the feminism, the third wave of feminism, is giving the protection for women. We'll show the women, you are very great women. You are able to be a leader, even you can dominate men. It doesn't mean that you are able, you should be lower than men. You should be not able to compete with men. This is what we're going to talk to you. Why the second layer? Why the liberal feminist prefer women is giving a better right for the women? Yeah.
Why don't you prove to us on how the current society women do not have the equal opportunity?
Yeah, of course, like you are talking about, for example, like women, they cannot use the sexiest clothes, and women are going to be raped. For example, when men can do slut, why women can do slut? This is the right of women to their body autonomy, how they control their body to be look like in the society, right? Even they use bikini, it doesn't mean that you see that this is a sexual object. We think that women have the right to prove themselves, to show their identity, who they are look like, right? And the second is that, we think that why the way of the liberalization of the women's right. Right now, women are achieving what they want to be. Right? For example, like when they get a better job, but then when they cannot get a depends on the man, it means that they're looking for the money, right? They should, for example, should have the, for example, for the women, for example, right now we see that the case of for example, divorced family, when women are get burdened, when they don't have the capabilities to grow their children. We think the problem is that how the women should be able to be independent, should be able to address the case of what they want to be a better life in terms of the for their quality of their life. And we think that the problems of right now, we don't want the right to regain the rights of the third wave feminism. Because of this third wave feminism, women look as women are looking for the protection, how the feminism should approach all the women to gain their rights until the end of the day. Thank you.
Still believe that feminist opposition still talk in the first layer and the second layer. They believe even the society still have the problematic in terms of showing the problematic of the society acceptance of the idea of women freedom. They talk about how there's still women cannot get such proper education and whatsoever. Then we believe that it's not really about the third world feminism, and it is proof to you how the third world is showing to you how the society is still not ready to face the third wave feminism part. That's why we believe that we should look at this simply because the society is still not ready, and how why the society is not ready. It then goes into such a bad treatment over this kind of belief, right? That's why we believe that we don't think that this religious matter so. And they also believe that how by the proposal, it's okay not to care because it's our body autonomous, it's okay not to care to the society. But we say that you cannot deny that women at the end of the day would jump in society, participate in the society, when basically women want to be acknowledged and want to be respected in the society, right? That's why we believe what the society says, the societal readiness over this kind of circumstances is really needed. And in your case, you are going to invoke the overgeneralization by the whole society that women want to be appraised that way. Women want to appraise in that sexual way. That's why we don't want those kind of things to be happen, and we are not going to support this kind of thing. So first, basically, why we sit down? Why we from the closing government of the house would like to regret? Because first, because they are backlashing feminist own idea. Why?
Yeah.
Because we believe the feminist main idea is to gender equality first, and second to empowering women. But what already happened there has already gone too far. They are asked for the exclusivity of the women. But we believe it's not good. Why? Because it's not manifesting the majority female voice. Why so? We all know about the third wave phenomenon, first of all, twerking and sort of freedom nipples. Why so? Because female not just include of the liberal female, also include of the conservative one. The conservative one also includes the part of the female body, right? Also the part of the feminist, right? That's why we believe, because it's all, this is not the female demands, this is not the whole female interest for being like this, simply because can be characterized based on the religion, also based on the culture. They are not representing the majority voice, this particular voice of the girls. That's why they can't name themselves as the feminists, they cannot name themselves as the feminists that ask for the freedom, because they ask for the freedom for the particular female only. That's why we believe it's not upgrading or not even uphold the feminist ideology. Sit down. And the second one, because by proposal, feminists would gain the negative social judgment by three kinds of social layers, first by the male, second by the gender society, last by the female. First, we are going to talk based on the females. The males first. Why it's unfair for the male? Because first, male already sacrificing their ego for both of the previous way. For the first way, female asks for the legal participation. Second, female asks for the social structure. Why? Male already sacrificing what? First, they need to accept the trend of co-parenting, that is the replacement of the patriarchal culture, right? When in this kind of condition, they also ask to be more respectful of the female. Okay, male already say that this is true. Male already grant this kind of thing to be happens in the status quo, right? But they keep demand more for this. For example, the free nipple case, when they are going to showing their body like they really want, they are going to use pastels, short clothes, for example. When this kind of condition, the one that women put at fault when the sexual assault happens, when this women using the same clothes, women still the male, right? It's still unfair for the male. And what happened for the male? Why? In this kind of condition, it will cause bad perception from the male to the female. What kind of bad perception? First, the reluctance to equality, the reluctance to support the idea of inequality. That's why they call the woman what happens anyway. And the second one, when the social jealousy would be happens. Why the social jealousy happens? Because society will, this kind of people, as male, as the power of society, will not even respected by the government, because this kind of thing that being demanded by the feminists being upheld at the very first place. We don't want that to be happens. We don't want this kind of bad situation on the social jealousy that even will be hampered equality that already exists nowadays and harmony of realities nowadays happens. That's why we are going to regret this kind of third wave feminists. And also the second, the general society. Why this is bad for this, or bad perception for the general society? Because this kind of thing will make a certain of rejection over the feminists because of the third wave nagging always. For example, they call us the feminists as the feminazi nowadays. The feminazi notion already exists in the society, right? Yeah. And they don't even see us in a positive perspective when we still need society, the general society, to circulating the message the new idea of the feminism would not be achieved anyway, then even the process of the equality will be even harder and even tower and tower. That's why we believe we don't want that kind of thing to be happen. And the last, sending the bad message to female themselves. First, we all know how the feminist critics can be distinguished into two kinds of feminists. First is first world country, and second also the third world country. Let's categorize the first one. The first world country, where the campaign happens, and not those people well educated. These all people well educated, and they know about their own context and how to use those kind of clothes. And the second world and also the third world feminist membership, when the idea of feminism is still in the second wave, that's why the society is still not ready, and also the female themselves is not ready with the idea of the third wave itself. But what will happen when they are using a bad clothes, or they are using this kind of clothes because of the notion of the third wave feminism in the different place, in the different context, where they would not be respected by using those kind of clothes. In this kind of condition, even the women are already degrading themselves more, and how this third world of countries will see that way. That's why we are going opposed.
Uncomfortable when they show or be like what they want. We don't want women being violated or feel free or threatened when actually they want to express themselves. This is where we should not depend on what actually the government has already proposed in this motion. First, rebuttal, ladies and gentlemen, that they believe right now government actually is not ready, setting up ready toward this next spring woman movement on the third wave. Well, we believe, ladies and gentlemen, first, that why the parameter of women or the society or government not ready should become the parameter on how government not to change their value or rules or policy, or why it become the parameter we have to ban this kind of the movement. First, ladies and gentlemen, we believe that the society's value actually something that maybe not change. Perspective will always be there, but what actually the people can do to survive, to also uploading their rights, is by making a movement. Take an example about the LGBT. Long time ago, people reject the LGBT, but right now, since the LGBT already exists, step by step, it's already become developed on how people accepting this kind of the value. Second example about on how black people, which is already being rejected a long time ago, but since there is some kind of non-apartheid policies or non-apartheid movement, it's already also becoming an advertisement for us. Hey, to accept that these people actually similar with us. It's actually, we have to change our value based on the meritocracy, ladies and gentlemen. Something like that. So basically, we believe that this is a parameter on how society's readiness or not could not become the valid parameter coming from the opening government to regret or not about some movement. Second of all, ladies and gentlemen, they also believe that the opposing government that say it's actually unfair for the men because the first wave and second wave is already violating the men's right to sit in parliament, for example. Well, duh, ladies and gentlemen, that actually people sit in parliament actually should be explored by men and women, not similarly being given by the men. A long time ago, maybe a lot of societies still undermine the women, so that indirectly there is banning for women to sit in parliament. But after the first wave and second wave, this is opening the chance and mindset of the society to accept women. Therefore, women can sit inside of this parliament, and it's something good right now, ladies and gentlemen. And the third of all, ladies and gentlemen, they also believe that the closing government believes that it will actually give negative labeling toward the woman itself, and also it will create backlashing toward the idea of body exposure or something like that. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we cannot put parameter whether or not someone will be comfortable or not when they expose their body. Actually, this movement also is a form of a choice. Whether you want to follow or whether you don't want to follow, actually we should not regret on this, ladies and gentlemen. It's a form on how you could respect yourself, you could also maximize your self-actualization, which actually will going to be my argumentation, as which make me different compared with the opening government, ladies and gentlemen. What makes our case is going to be very exclusive in here? First, why right now, ladies and gentlemen, it's important for the woman to have self-actualization, which has become the part of the freedom of expression, which is not becoming half parameter just based on society's stigmatization. Second of all, ladies and gentlemen, we believe also when the government regained this right, it means government interfere the right, which is actually not violating harm or which is not harming other people, and it's something that's wrong. The third argument, ladies and gentlemen, why we need this third wave as an extreme movement to make people aware that there is something needs to be free to make other people also to uphold their self-actualization. Now going to the first argumentation, ladies and gentlemen. Right now, it's a form of self-definition towards the movement itself. We believe that right now people have their own self freedom of expression, ladies and gentlemen. People maybe want to work without having some kind of clothes. Even in some area, in traditional area, people of women or women itself is still surplus, ladies and gentlemen. Do you want this traditional, which also they want to maintain, is considered as based as negative stigma? We don't want it happen, ladies and gentlemen. We also want this tradition become respected. Of course, basic movement exists, ladies and gentlemen. Second of all, ladies and gentlemen, we believe also that these women could express their self-actualization because they don't violate another people. They only, for example, taking photographs, being naked, they want to show about their beautiful body. Well, if you compare to a man, I'm sure all, most of you here also like women with the six-pack, especially for the girl or for the gay. But the thing is, ladies and gentlemen, the beautifulness of the body itself could not be separated for men only, and then women being neglected. Because I believe men also could be exposed toward their six-pack, or toward their breasts, and also toward their muscles. This is something that we want to uphold, how we can create equality instead of the self-actualization toward the woman, ladies and gentlemen. Now, if we actually relate to the self-determination that will lead to the confidence of the woman, maybe that the woman are still being undermined, hey, women should be done, men on top. We don't want it to happen again. We believe that women actually should have equal position here, that they are not being discriminated by any people or even by the society, ladies and gentlemen. Now, going to the second argument, why when the government regret toward this, actually it will create some kind of violation toward the rights for the people whom toward and also want to uphold some kind of value. We believe right now government could not interfere your rights. For example, rights for you to consume about onimax, for example, consume drafting day or something, for example, or maybe you want to expose your body in front of the people. Actually, it's something that makes you comfortable and confidence, and it doesn't disturb people. Why? Because people also could choose whether they want to watch it or people don't want to watch it. So basically, this actually parental already creates some kind of filterization and already being on by the society's awareness right now. When they are claiming that society's right now, it's not sufficient, ladies and gentlemen, to filtering something. It's something also wrong. Because why? When the sexual movement happens, a lot of society also will see and consider whether they want to support or whether they don't support. But even if so, ladies and gentlemen, we believe that the government right now, when they don't interfere toward this right itself, on how government will be responsible as the natural body, which is they also respecting this movement, because the government could not ban the existence of this movement, which is not violating any right of the people. Now going to the third argument, ladies and gentlemen, why right now the extreme movement as the third wave is something that necessarily could be happened and not be regretted, ladies and gentlemen. We also still questioning why we have to regret any kind of something which is make people get away, because it's something that make people actually put create something like, wow, oh, this is something that makes me shocked. It also will create more people awareness and more, and make another people have some kind of the support toward this movement, ladies and gentlemen. If a long time ago there is no LGBT movement, if a long time ago there is no non-apartheid movement, I believe right now the black people will stand on the ground, ladies and gentlemen. We believe also LGBT is not going to come up right now, like this for the example. So we believe the idea of how government creates comfortableness, how the idea also will make this woman have confidence position and also doing some kind of self-actualization should be responded without having parameter standard that the government is not ready or society is not ready, ladies and gentlemen. We believe that ready or not, this right should be avoided and channeled, because the channel itself, ladies and gentlemen, is a form of the option. You are giving some kind of the option to the society who can consider themselves, fair consideration whether you want to follow or not. Basically, we believe that this motion should fall. Thank you.
When they say that the society itself not really, but they are going to push it, for the same channel. We believe on the idea, that's what we catch over their proposal. We believe on the idea that one, the society is never ready enough, but then they are pushed into this third wave feminist movement. Then the idea of the policy itself will be ineffective at the end of the day, ladies and gentlemen. The idea that portrayed by the first or the second feminist movement since the first place will be devastated by the third feminist movement itself. And they also say that this might be optional for the parties over the third wave movement itself, ladies and gentlemen. We believe that it will impose a threat at the end of the day towards the feminist itself, ladies and gentlemen, over the society perception. We could not deny that, for example, let me portray to you months ago that ISIS bombed Paris, then there discussion where society think that Islam is a terrorist religion because it is claimed as belong to Islam religion, ladies and gentlemen. Society tend to over generalize every single thing in the society itself, ladies and gentlemen. For example, one black people kill each other in the society. There is a society perception that these black people are criminals in the society itself, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, we say that women do not demand such third wave movement itself, ladies and gentlemen. This isn't what they want, ladies and gentlemen. Because actually, in this situation and condition right now, they actually agree that the gender equality and such a chaotic condition is still appear in the society itself, ladies and gentlemen. Means that they agree that the first and the second movement is still working over the society itself, ladies and gentlemen. Here, we believe that the previous status quo is valid enough, ladies and gentlemen. That the first and the second feminist movement itself is trying to promote, is trying to introduce their goal over the society, ladies and gentlemen. No, sir. Not only that society has opened for them the access over the society to be accepted, but also some particular society has put a good perception towards this feminist movement, ladies and gentlemen. Here, why actually we think that feminists crave for their life and for their right and for their equality? Because actually, their right and their equality is still being violated in the society itself, ladies and gentlemen. Then what happened? Ladies and gentlemen, we do not want to leave the problem behind, ladies and gentlemen. We need to solve the society paradigm itself. We need to solve the problem over the gender inequality the first time, ladies and gentlemen. That if all the things is actually finished or done by the feminism itself, they can come to the new step, to the new policy that they are going to implement such a critical action, for example, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, we believe that the essence of feminism since the very first place, they want to face the female and women around the world, ladies and gentlemen. But because this case, we believe that they will able to push themselves to do anything to be accepted. Then, do we let them to do anything wrong, ladies and gentlemen? No, right? Because yes, they are trying to gain more attention. Yes, they are trying. Yes, they are. They are succeed to gain the attention at all. But then, at the end of the day, it is a bad attention towards them, ladies and gentlemen. No, sir. Because they will be judged by the society itself, ladies and gentlemen. Because the first and the second wave movement itself actually has portrayed the good stigmatization towards the society that here they are existing in the society and they are belong to the part of the society. But then we believe that the existence of the third movement itself will devastate all the goal, will devastate all the paradigma and the paradigms that created by the second and the first feminist movement itself, ladies and gentlemen. So here, we believe that as a good government, we need to lead our society, ladies and gentlemen. We are able to consider which thing is profitable for the society itself, ladies and gentlemen. By agreeing the wave third feminist movement, they are trying to neglect the issues over the women itself in the society, ladies and gentlemen. In the social environment, which is still crucial and need to be fixed and repaired since the very first place, ladies and gentlemen. Such domestic violence, such unfairness in job vacancy itself, ladies and gentlemen. That's why feminists, by the first and the second feminism, need to voice out loud about this case because it does not finish at all, ladies and gentlemen. They shouldn't let their basic goal to actually promote or introduce something so extreme to the society itself that society might think, no, actually they are demanding a lot from us. That's not what I actually need to do, ladies and gentlemen. And also, we have proven to you why the grants is effective here, ladies and gentlemen, because actually it's backlashing the feminist ideology itself and also endanger the women in social life itself, ladies and gentlemen. Why do we believe that government intervention and such is very crucial here, ladies and gentlemen? Because actually, government shouldn't fulfill a lot of need coming from from the society itself, ladies and gentlemen. They should be able to see which one is actually needed by the society, which one is actually could be or possibly accepted by the society very well or not, ladies and gentlemen. Pushing these things will never be effective until the end of the day, ladies and gentlemen, because actually the government just lacked another party of the feminist movement itself to actually devastate, to actually backlashing their previous group, ladies and gentlemen, which actually portrayed to us that the feminism is not always bad. Feminist movement is not always something that you need to put aside from the society itself, ladies and gentlemen. So that's why we believe that this motion still stands at the end of the day, because we bring the effectiveness over our proposal. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the member of the House, the team in black are going to clarify all the things regarding towards the case of opening and closing of government. They're saying, ladies and gentlemen, that the regret because there is going to be the idea of perception and public discourse at the right now, which is going to be very, very better and beneficial for this community. Number one, tell me, we think that the idea of perception has been there forever. We cannot change people's mindset because we born as a different perspective, we are different of thought. And that's not going to be a parameter for us to be regretted like they're talking about. Public discourse has benefit. Number one, at least that's going to be a parameter of public discussion that people are going to gathering together to clarify. At least better for this community to clarify something that Clara saying that they're going to be labeled as feminazi. We think as Japan there is always the idea of women to clarify something, at least to be there, the life, to do that, to defend their life, that these women are not that bad. Therefore, we think we need to let this movement to be happen in the society right now. Under that idea, I'm going to introduce directly to my rebuttal. Under the idea that parameter to be regretted just because society never ready or just because society is not ready. How could you determine society is not ready? With by logic, there will of course there is a huge possibility people will ready. So there is something wrong with it, right? Because only butchers, people will keep, people will change their behavior regardless for this. The idea is that gentlemen, when people are women are going to go to the extreme way, why should be a parameter to satisfy people in general, right? Because we think individual, something like can determine what is something bad and for only this individual, because this individual knows better situation compared to other society right now. Just because society don't like this idea doesn't mean this individual will also do not like what you are talking about as people in general. Ladies and gentlemen, we don't know if something why, for example, that woman and actually should only satisfy the man with the criteria like they're talking about. We also regret with the idea where society have created a standard that the fat female are not going to be there. Okay, in terms of fulfilling job vacancy, for example. Therefore, gentlemen, we are opposing and we also legitimately okay to have this feminist movement. We also try to justify what happened in India right now. Even we justify toward the act of Gula began in order to respond the idea that the government are less protection of the woman. In India right now, what is the situation that women in India are being oppressed? Women in India are being victimized of raping. And also, gentlemen, in that moment, we also justify that the act of vigilantism created by this Gula began. Because, number one, we regret for the government exists. They are not even fully 100% protecting the women there. Therefore, this movement exists. We think that is okay when something actually, when they're saying that women are too much demanding, that's okay. Because there is something wrong happened that cannot be fixed by the government right now. But therefore, gentlemen, it becomes a matter of criticism with the government to let this to happen and nothing to be regretted at all. Opening government simply is saying that, no, because it is against the norms. We think as gentlemen that the value in society right now is not that absolute. We should not set standard based on what people perception. What I've told you before that if the simply just people do not like you, then this society will always obey forever until the end of their life to always obey and the rest of life only for obeying this progressive of the people. Very good, yes.
You are wrong. I cannot take we need to go into society perception. Why they are wrong? Because we believe that at the end of the day, these women will go jump into the society, right?
At least prove to me that we can have best mechanism to alter people's behavior in our perception. Because even if you are acting as a good people, also there's always haters like me. Even I'm good as a debater, but always in effect, also have a haters. And that's the reason that it could be a parameter for you and your team to regret me, to have to always active in debating idea. That's not going to be action, objective at all. It's not creating parameter of standard. Not to extend the case of closing of opposition. Number one, we think nothing to be rejected at all. Even opening the
government are failed to create some other parameter. What is actually something something parameter context regretful. First, at least they can say to us what these women do are actually harming other people with the intent of rational calculation that these women are not that stupid, right? For example, when these women are going to be prostitutes, for example, and there is no way to say this are immoral. Number one, if there is a choice in ideal situation that women under the low economic, there will be no effort to choose to be prostitute. But hence, exactly right now, simply labeling this woman as a bitch, simply labeling this woman as not that morality, for example, and that's totally bad. That's why we have this idea of femininity. It's happened, Jaman. Number two, in terms of rational calculation also, that this individual can have a better calculation in terms of actually something bad and good for them. However, it is said, Jaman, that the result or the consequences also being tackled by this individual, not you. Number two, in terms of the idea of optional, we think that by having this community, we also want to channeling people or women who are not confident enough. For example, ladies and gentlemen, under the logic that the woman using surplus something categorized as immoral person, for example, and that's not good. We think when people have the choices and through this movement, people or women can deliberate themselves, can actualize themselves to be as what they are want to be. Like that's exactly why people or women have like fully in terms of living in comfortability era without no more longer the idea of oppression coming on this opening and closing of government. Yeah. Second of all, it starts on the idea of government. We think that the government should not only voice up into the majority interest because it's not even satisfied toward the minority like this woman also. Mm-hmm. We know that the government also need to hear the aspiration and the sad feeling of this woman, how they are feeling in oppressed society right now. Under that idea, we're assuming that they will let this woman leave behind also because they're rejecting this idea of feminism, ladies and gentlemen. So in 6 minutes, I'm going to prove to you why we think that the government has no right to infringe on individual choices based on what is necessity and based on what's actually benefit for them. What is actually based on necessity right now? We think that there is no parameter to determine people's interest. There is no parameter to determine people's happiness, what they're going to be in the future. For example, maybe that this woman are actually there's not even like capability doing something. Therefore, this woman are actually forcing by the condition to be as prostitute. You think that this woman are legitimately okay beyond this way, ladies and gentlemen. We also need to uphold equal opportunity in terms of accessibility, something for example. If men are okay to do something, we also need to say okay towards the woman to do something because it's under their consent, it's under their agreement, there's no idea of forcing coming from the government of society right now. We need to at least say to the society right now that what you are doing right now is not even reflecting to the idea of democracy. So we believe that the factor team who are really the factor team is actually are too hard to fight all the battles here. We need to work and to go to this factor team.